Hello everyone, welcome to CAT tutorials for beginners. So today I am recreating this fresh video tutorial regarding the 21 types of sweeps in CATIA. So we'll understand each type of the sweep one by one with the examples. So if you like the video and if it is really found helpful for you, please do like it, share it, and if you have any queries then you can add it in the comment box below, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. And also press the bell icon to get notified for the upcoming videos. So yeah, let us start for the tutorial. So let us understand total 21 types of sweeps, which are they. So now I have consolidated this file over here for the complete 21 types of sweeps, and we will understand which are those sweeps here. So now there are four types here, and if you see here, the first one is the explicit, that is the main type. Second is the line type, and the third is the circular type, and the last one, that is the conic type. So now each of these main types have their subtypes. So for the explicit, there are the width surface with the reference surface. Second is the width two guide curves. Then with pulling direction, and for the line again we have the two limits, the limits and the middle, and then there is with surface, with reference curve, with tangency curve, with drop direction, and the last one, that is with two tangency surface. And again for the circle, that is two guide curves, then there is a two guides and radius. The third one is center and two angles. Fourth is center and radius. The fifth one is two guides and tangency surface. Then one guide and tangency surface. And the last one is limit curve and the tangency surface. And again for the conic, that is the fourth type, there are two guide curves, three guide curves, four guide curves, and the last one, that is. Now we will start with the explicit type with reference surface first. So let us start with the shape design here. Go to the start shape and then the generative shape design. So I will name here, that is the rib with reference surface. So just make this one capital and just click OK. So here first we will check what are the inputs required for this with reference surface option. So we will find the option over here, and you can see here the sweep command. So we will first see all these options which we have seen over here for the complete 21 sweeps. So now this is first, that is a profile type, that is the explicit. And you can find the subtype of this one, that is with reference surface, with two guide curves, with pulling direction. Then there is the second type, that is line type. And in this you can see here, the first one is the two limits. Then there is a limits and middle, with reference surface, with reference curve, with tangency surface, with drop direction, and with two tangency surfaces. Again, there is same third type here, that is the circle, and you can find here the three guides, two guides and radius, center and two angles, center and radius, two guides and the tangency surface. Then there is one tangency, one guide and tangency surface, limit curve and tangency surface. Then the last type, that is the conic one. So in that two guide curves, three, four and five guide curves. So basically first we will start with this explicit one, and we'll select this with reference surface. So you can find here the profile, that is we have to select the profile here which we want to sweep. Then there is the guide curve definition, that is we have we should have some guide curve available here, and you can find here the preview of that picture over here. You can definitely understands from here that this one is the profile, that is the profile you are going to sweep, and here there is the guide curve available. So we will see this one in the example. So let us draw one sketch here. I will use this positioning sketch. and I will draw on the front plane. Yeah, so we'll use this arc here, and we have to select the center first, then the first point and the second point here. So these are the 2 points we have to select for the arc. You can just dimension it. I will make the radius for 50. So this is my first profile that I am going to sweep, and just exit the workbench. And now I will use the second sketch over here. So make sure that the profile and the guide curve should be in the two different sketches. So you can swap it here for the orientation purpose. And now I will use here the spline command just to have some curvature over here, and along this curvature I will just use this sweep command, and you can use here the project command for this one. So to project this point over here, and you can just make it, you can use this sketch tool and you can make it projection, that is a hidden lines. Just use this normal command and then select this one, select this point and select these 2 points here. Just make them coincidence. I will just keep it down and just exit the workbench. So now I have the profile available and the guide curve with me. So now I can use this sweep option. So just select on the sweep, and now here select the width reference surface, and the profile is this one and the guide curve is this one, and just you can just preview it. So you can see the profile is swept along that guide curve, and just click OK. So now I will make some changes over here. Let us try changing this guide curve over here. Just keep some low and then just exit it. So in this way you can create this sweep with the help of explicit type, and within that with the reference surface. So yes, make it save this. I will save it. Go to the desktop and I will save here the sweep command, and I have already the name available, so I'll just save it. So now we will see the second type, that is the two guide curves. With the two guide curves, we will see this option now in the explicit type. So again, we'll first see, we'll just close this one. So I will close this example here, and again I will go to the shape and generate a shape design, and here I will add width two guide curves. I'll just click OK, and now again we will see what are the inputs required for this option. So again I will select the profile tab that is explicit. We'll go to the subtype, and here I will select the width two guide curves, and here you will find the profile it is required, and then there is a guide curve 1 and guide curve 2. So there are total 3 inputs are required from our side for the execution of this sweep. So here if you see, you can find here this is a profile, that is G1, P and G2. So if you find here, this is a profile over here, and this G1, that is G1, if you see here this side, so this is the guide curve 1, and this G2 is the guide curve 2. So you can definitely understand from this picture as well. So let us check with the help of example. So I will just create one profile once again. Again I will select the arc here, create a semicircle, and then I will again provide a radius to it, let's say 50. Just exit the workbench. Again make sure that the sketch and the profile must be in a separate sketches. Also, the two guide curves must be in a different sketches. So two guide curves cannot be in the same sketch. So let us create two guide curves over here. And just create this one. So now again I will use the spline command. Again I will create a simple guides here. This is the first one, and then again I will create a second one. And then I will use the dimension command, and here for with the help of the constraint I will make it coincidence. Similarly I will make it coincidence, and now you can just exit the workbench. So again we have made the mistake over here, and I have to delete this one. So I would deliberately use this same sketch. If you use the sketch like this, then the two separate guide curves cannot be selected. So again I will use the sketch positioning, and so reverse this one. So again I will use this spline over here, and again here I will use this constraint command. Select the constraint and make them coincidence. So the condition is like the two sketches, all the three sketches must be in the different sketches, and the guide curve must be in contact with this profile. So now we have the profile here, we have the guide curve 1 and the guide curve 2. So now we can use this command over here, sweep command, and now we will select the two guide curves. So select the profile first, then you can use the guide curve 1. So you can just select the sketch as well, or you can directly click on the profile itself and then use the guide curve 2 and just try previewing. So you can see here the sweep is created, and just click OK. So now again we'll make some changes over here. Let us try changing this profiles over here. Just select this one, and again I will exit this, and I will change the profile for this one. You can see here what is happens. So you can see here the profile is getting changed as per the guide curves. So now we will use some more options over here. You can see here there is a spine, by default it is selected as sketch 2. So here again we have two options available, that is the relimiter 1 and relimiter 2. So we'll see what happens with this. So now we will create one plane over here. Just create a plane, and we'll create the offset from the plane. So just select the reference plane here, and then I will reverse it in the other direction and just move it little inside, and then click OK. So again so we are using this relimiter 1. So if we preview it, so it is just relimiting till that plane here. So in this way you can add the relimiter option over here. Again if you want some more, you can use the different options and just click OK. So again if you make it preview, so you can see here the sweep between these two relimiters, that is a plane 1 and plane 2. This is the plane 1 and this is the plane 2. It is created, and we can directly create it here by clicking the right click, or we can create the plane separately as well, and we can select it as a relimiter. So just click OK. So in this way you can use this option for creating the sweep. So now we will see the third option. So again, before going to third option, we will just save this. So just save it in the same folder we are going to save it. So with two guide curves, we'll just save it. So now again, I will close this one and we will go to this. That is the width pulling direction. So just we will see how to make a sweep with the help of width pulling direction. So again, just go to the start command and then go to the shape. Then there is a generative shape design. And here I will add the name, that is width pulling direction. Just click OK, keep the other options as it is. And now again, we will see what are the inputs required for this option. So again, go to the sweep command. And again, with the explicit type, we have to select this width pulling direction. So here, if you see here, we require the profile that we need to sweep. And then there is a guide curve. So along with guide curve, we need to sweep the profile. And there is a direction. So we have to specify the direction here for the sweep. So just see how it can be done with the example. So first I will create the profile here. Let's create the profile immediately. Use the arc here. Again the semicircle. Provide the dimension for the same, that is 50 radius. And then just exit the workbench. And now I will simply create one guide curve here. Use the constraint for the, just escape it first. Select the constraint. Sorry, it is not selecting the point. Just select the point and make them constraints so that the profile must be connecting with the guide curve. So now we can use the option, go to the sweep and then just use the, select the profile here, select the guide curve. So provide the direction here. I will just provide the Z direction. And then you can just preview it. So now you can see here there are multiple options here, one of four. So these are the four possibility of having this sweep. So you have to select as per your requirement. So if you see, if you click on the next button and if you just preview it, you can find here the differences in the sweep here. Again, if I click on the fourth one, then you will find the differences. So you have to select based on your requirement here. So similarly, if you have if you use the relimiter one, you can cut the profile within the two planes or any surface you can select from the here. So again, you can see the relimiter one and relimiter option two here, and you can change the angle from here. So you can change the so if you see here this angle, if you try to change this angle, you can find it here. It is going to be changed. So let us try changing it to some extent. So let us so you can see here the angle, it is going to change to 21 degree. So in this way you can use this option with the pulling direction for creating the sweep. So again, I will save this option. So I will just control save and then with the pulling direction in the same folder, I will just save it. So I will just close this example here. And then now we will move to the second type. That is the line type. And in that we will again see these options, that is the two limits first, and then we'll see one by one. So let's start. So again, let us start with the shape design. Go to the generative shape design and here just add the name, that is two limits, with two limits. Raise the options as it is. And then again, if you see the inputs required, you just go to the sweep command, and here you need to select the profile type, that is line. And then if you see here, there are a lot of options available, so we'll select the first option, that is the two limits. So here if you find here the inputs required are for the sweep here, the guide curve 1 and the guide curve 2. So let us create the example, and with the example we will understand how to use this sweep. So again, I will use the sketch command. Let's create the two guide curves. So we'll select the top plane and then just swap it. So I will use this. Let's create a line here. Just exit this. So this is my first guide curve, and then again I will create the second one. Select the line and just create the same line and then exit this. So now I have the two guide curves available here. Now you can I can use this option. So just go to this sweep command and then make sure the profile is a line type, and then you can select the two limits option. So select the guide curve 1 and then select the guide curve 2. So if we see here, you can see here, this is the guide curve 1 and this is the guide curve 2. So these are the two guide curves available here, and just make it preview. So if you see, the sweep is added, and the main point is here is that the two limits option is basically used for the linear transformation only, not for the curvature type. So again, you can add the relimiter options over here. You can add over the plane inside, and you can use this relimiter option. So let us try adding it. Just create a plane over here, and we'll just use this. And just click OK. So if you preview it, sorry, it is not going to be cut here. So just try here selecting, and just select the plane in a proper manner, and then if it is intersecting, it is going to relimit it. So if you see the preview here, so you can see here the split or the trim operation is impossible because the input bodies do not intersect each other. So we'll just make some changes. So as it is not going to intersect over here, we'll just make the changes. And we'll just see the preview here. So you can see the relimiter is added in this direction. So it is not going to be intersected in this direction. So similarly, you can add the length 1. So you can add, you can see here. So if you see here, this one, this area. And again, if you use this option for the length 2 option, so you can see here some changes happening here. You can see here the dimension. So it is showing 37 mm. So it is showing blur, but it is 37. So again, I will use this sweep option. Select the guide curve 1. Select the guide curve 2 here. Make a preview. Then if you want to add the relimiter, you can add the relimiter here. Select the plane in the reverse direction and just click OK. Just make it a preview. And then you can just adjust this length here. So you can see, and if you preview it, so it is going to add that much length here. Again, similarly, if you want to add the length 2 in the other direction, you can just have this length as well and just click OK. So in this way, you can use this sweep option for the limits, two limits, for creating the sweeps. So now we will see the other options, that is the limit and the middle. So first, before going to the next option, we will just save it. Just make it control save and save it. So again, I will just close this one. And again, for the next option, that is the limit and the middle. So we'll see this option now. So let us start with the shape, then to the generative shape design, and here just add the name, that is the limit and middle. Just click OK. And now again, if you see the inputs required for this option, that is the limits and the middle. So you will require here the guide curve one. So you see here, this is the guide curve one, and then the guide curve two. So you can see here, this is the middle two, or this one is used as a guide curve. So you can see here, the two white lines are the guide curves. So we'll create the profile here. So we can go to the sketch. So just sketch on the top plane, select the lines, and create a line here for the guide curve one. Similarly, I will create the other guide here in the same plane. Just again click this line and create the second line over here. Exit the workbench. So now go to the sweep. So select the guide curve one, and then select the guide curve 2. So this will be as a middle. So you can see here, this is a middle and this is a guide curve 1. And then if you see the preview, you can see here, this is the in the middle and this is the first guide curve. So the intention is to have this guide curve in the middle. So again, if you see OK, you can see here, this is properly in the middle of this surface. So if I double click this, so again, you will have the options available here for the relimiter 1 and the relimiter 2. So we'll keep this as it is. You can try these options at home. So I will just close this one. And again, I will just save this one. Save it to the same folder. And now go to the third option. So that is the with reference surface in the line profile type. So again, I will just close this one, and again, we will understand with the help of example. So go to the generative shape design, and here just add the with reference type, reference surface, and here I will add the line. So because the with reference surface was in the explicit also, so this is line type. So just create a file here, and again we will see what are the inputs required for this option. So if you see this option, that is a with reference surface, so you have to select the guide curve one, and you should have the reference surface. And again, we can add the angle over here. So we will create the guide curve one, and then we will create the reference surface here. So again, go to the sketcher and just draw on the top plane here. So first I will create the guide curve here. Just create one guide curve. So we'll just create guide curve as well as the surface. So we'll just extrude this with the help of extrude command. So just provide here the direction. That is the y direction, and you can just add this limit here. So I have this reference created now, and I can use this option for creating the reference surface. So now go to the sweep surface, and now in the reference surface, just select the guide curve. So you can select this guide curve, that is the edge of this extrude edge, and you can have this reference surface here. If you see preview, you can see here the surface that is swept. So you can add the length over here as per your requirement. So let's say this is 50. So in this way you can just use the reference surface and a guide curve to create the, that is for the extension of the surface. So again I will double click, and you have the length 2 as well here. You can change the length 2. You can have the relimiters 1, relimiters 2 for here, for the, for restricting the surface within the two planes or a surface. So you can use this one as well. So you just try it, and if you have some queries you can add in the comment box below. And if you like our videos, you can just subscribe our channel, like the videos and share the videos. Just click OK. So again I will just add, I will click on the control save, sorry, and just save it in the same folder. So now the next option, that is the with reference curve. So we will see how to use this with reference curve option. So again I will just close this window, and then we'll use this, go to the start shape and the generative shape design. So here I will add, so add a name here with reference curve, and just click OK. So now again we will see what are the inputs required for this one. So just go to the with reference curve, and here if you see we need the guide curve 1 and then the reference curve. So we need this two curves here, the guide curve 1 and the reference curve. So again here you can see here the guide curve is the curve that you are going to swap, and along with the reference curve. So we'll just create it with the example. Just create the sketch in the front plane, and then use the arc option. Again we will use the arc to create the semicircle, and then we will add the radius. We'll exit this. So now this is my guide curve 1, and now I have to create the reference surface, that is a reference curve. So now for the reference curve, we'll use this plane here, and then just select the front plane in the reverse direction, and just move this approximate distance, so not that much, and then click OK. So now I'll just sketch on this plane, and here draw one profile, simply a line I will draw here. And now this is my reference curve here. So now go to the sweep option, and here just select the guide curve 1, and then select the reference curve here. And now again here you can find here the with the angular sector you can have till 4 possibilities. So you can see one by one. So we'll just first see the first possibility here. If you just preview it, you can see here the sweep is created, but with this length 1 direction and the length 2. You can see here the length 1 is 20, and you will find it here. If you zoom it, you can find here this is the 20. So we will change this dimension over here. Let us try changing this. So just add let's say 40. Now make a preview, and then again just add this length 2 here. So here let us add 60. So you can see here the sweep is created. I will just add again 100. So in this way you can create this sweep here. So you can also add one, also modify this one as well, little more, just make it 50. And just click OK. So in this way, you can use this option for creating the sweep. Again, I will double click for the modification purpose, and you can just try changing this angle as well for the specific profile as per your requirement. So you can see here with the angle, you can see here this angle is here, and the profile it's getting, you can see here it is rotated by this angle. So you can see here this is a 9 degree, and again if you try increasing this one, just try increasing, so you can see here the arrows, so it is not visible. So just make it little low, and you can see here the 30 degree. So it is showing the error because it is going out of its limit, out of its possibility. So that's why it is showing the error. So you can see here with the 30 degree, it is showing this angle here. So again, I will make some control Z, and now I'll keep this as it is. So in this way, we can use this option with a reference curve for creating the sweep. So now again, I will just control save it, and then with a reference curve, I will save it in the same folder. Just close this before going to the next point. So now for the next option, that is we have seen with reference surface, with reference curve, and then the next option is with tangency surface. So we'll see this option. Again, go to the start, go to the shape, go to the generative shape design, and here just add a name, that is the with tangency surface. Keep the options as it is and then click OK. So now again, we will see what are the inputs required for this option. Go to the sweep command, and keeping the profile line type, just select the, sorry, I have selected the wrong one. Just select the with tangency surface. So here, if you see, you require the guide curve one, then there is a tangency surface. So if you see this image here, I will zoom it. So you can see here the image, there is a G1, that is the guide available there. You can see that white line. And then there is a S, that is the guide curve one. And that S is a extruded, that is the tangency surface. So we'll see how to create this sweep with the help of example. So we have to create the guide curve one and the tangency surface. So again, I will just draw a profile in the front plane. And again, with the help of arc, we'll create the semicircular profile here. Just provide the radius, that is 35, and then exit the workbench. So with the help of extrude command, just extrude it. And then click OK. So this is my tangency surface here, and now we will create the guide curve. So again, before going to sketch, I will just add one more plane here for the side plane, and just add here, let's make it 50 offset. So now go to the sketch and sketch on this plane, keeping this coordinates as it is, and use a line here, just create one line, and then exit the workbench. So yeah, this is my guide curve, and this is the tangency surface. So now I will go to this sweep option, and here keep this option selected, that is the with tangency surface. So select the guide curve one, just select the guide curve one and add this tangency surface. So if you make a preview here, you can see here the surface that is tangent to this tangency surface is created here, and from this guide curve one. So just create a OK. And now you can see here the tangency surface is created. So again, let us try modifying this guide curve here to make complete tangency. So go to the sketch 2 and I will just extend this. So just exit the workbench and you can see here the complete surface is created tangent to this surface. So again, if you modify this offset here, so you can see here it is updated automatically. Again, there are options available here to add relimeter, to add relimeter 2. You can add this both the options here. So again, you can try this. If you have any queries, you can add it in the comment box below. I will definitely try to solve each and every queries. So yeah, that's it for this command. Again, I will just control save it and will save this with a tangency surface. So again, I will close this window here and now we will see the next option, that is a with draft direction. So again, to start with the shape and generative shape design and add a name here with draft direction. Keep the other option as it is. So now go to the option sweep command. You will understand what are the inputs required for this command here. Just select the with draft direction and you can see here the inputs required are the guide curve one and then the draft direction. So these are the two options required here. So here again you can change the angle, you can change the length 2. So you can change these options and again you will find here the possibilities, whatever the possibilities are there. So just we'll see how to do it with the example. Again, go to the sketch and just draw on the front plane. So again, I will create the profile here, select the center, select the first point and then select the second point. Provide the radius here. Just add randomly, that is 35. So this is my guide curve here and we will select the draft direction based on the x-axis, y-axis and the z-axis and we can add the angle. So let us go to the command, that is a sweep, and then keep the option selected, that is a with draft direction. Just select the guide curve one and try here that is a draft direction in the x direction and just make a preview. So you can see here the sweep is created and the angle is 0 degree here. So if you try changing the angle, so the angle is getting changed here. Again, just try and make it bigger and you can see here clearly it is showing here the draft angle is added. So similarly, add some more draft here and try previewing it. So you can see now it is clearly showing that there is an angle and that is around 17 degree. So now it's 20 degree and here you can again increase this length over here. You can find here the length is changing. So I will just keep increasing it and then we will preview it. So now you can see here the length, that is a length one. Here it is 67 and the draft angle provided here is 20 degree. So you again you can try changing the length 2 as well. So now you can see here on the other side of the axis or other side of this ZY plane, the draft is getting added and the sweep is getting added. So you can just add let's say 12 and you can see here the sweep is added with a 12 mm length. Again, here there are multiple possibilities available. You can see the orientation is changed now. The third possibility is this one. and the fourth one is this one. So you can see here there are four possibilities for this kind of sweep. Here you can use, you can select as per your requirement. So I will keep this first option as it is here. And here you will have the length type one. There are multiple options here, that is from curve. So the length getting started from the curve. Then there is a second option, that is a standard one. Then there is a third one, that is from up to. Then there is a from extremum. So there are multiple options here. You can try as per your requirement. Again here there are from curve option. So just click OK for accepting this type of sweep. Again you can double click and you can modify at any point of time. So if you see here the option, that is the length type one. So if you select the from curve, so it is going to start from the curve, and your length one option is getting disabled, and it is going to be extended only in the length two direction. So if you just try and select this one, so you can see here the length one is going to be 0 mm, and if you see preview, so it is going to be 0, and only in the one direction you can add the length. Again if you use the second option, that is the standard one, so it is a standard one that we have used for the first time. You can add the 60, so it is going to add the length, that which is 60, on the other side as well. So then there is an option that is from and up to. So you can add the relimiter here. So you can see here the relimiting element one is, you can add here. So you can add the plane surface, you can add whatever the option available here. So just try creating the plane here. I will select the front plane. I will keep in the reverse direction and just click OK. So now my relimiter is getting added here, and you can see the, based on the relimiter, so it is going to relimit the surface. So similarly you can try for the length 2 as well. So in this way you can use this option with a drop direction. So again I will just save this option, and I will save it in the same folder. So, and now I will close this window. And then now we have seen this drop direction. Now we'll see the last option, that is the width to tangent surface. So we'll see in this line type, it is the last one. So we'll see that. Again, let's skip this one, and then we'll go to the shape, generative shape design, and add here the name, that is two tangency surfaces. Just click OK. So again, we will see what are the inputs required. Go to the sweep option, and then just go to the last option, that is with two tangency surfaces. Just select that. And here you will find, you will require the spine, then you will require the first tangent surface, you will require the second tangent surface. So there are three inputs required from your side. So you can see here that S1, this is the first tangent surface here, the S2, that is the second tangent surface, and this is the C1, that is the spine graded here. So you can see from the image as well, and you can understand the input requirement for the command. So we'll use this example and we'll create this sweep. So just follow these types. So again I will use the arc here and add the dimension, let's say again 50, and then exit this. Again create the another sketch on the same plane, that is the front plane, and here again just try, sorry, just select this one and select the second point. Again provide the radius. I will keep this radius as it is, that is 50. So you can make a constraint with the help of this one. So I will keep this as it is, just for the illustration purpose. And now you can just extrude this two guides here. So just extrude in the reverse direction, or you can just keep the both sides. Similarly, I will extrude this surface as well. I'll click OK. So now I have these two surfaces here. So you can see here in the command, you will require the first tangent surface and you will require the second tangent surface. So we have these two tangent surfaces available with us. So now we have to create the spline. So just close this one. So now we'll create the spine. So we just use this plane offset, and again I will add the 50. So as we know already, we have this 50 radius. We will create the spine on the same plane. So just select this plane here, make it reverse, and then click OK. So just create the spine over here to create this spine as it is, and then exit the workbench. So now we have the two tangent surface and with this spine available. So go to the sweep. Just select the spine first, select the first tangent surface and select the second tangent surface and just make a preview. So you can see the tangent surface is getting added with the help of this both these options. So if you click OK, you can see here the sweep is created. And again, if you want to remove this both the surfaces here, unwanted surfaces here, then you can again use these options available here. You can see here the trim with tangent surface. You can just use this trim with the tangent surface, and then there is another option that is a trim with second tangent surface. So just check these two options, and if you preview it, just click OK. So now you can see here both the surfaces getting removed. Again, I will double click it. So similarly, you can add the relimiter here. If you want to add relimiter here, you can add it to just restrict the surface within that two relimiters. So again, I will keep this as it is here and just make a preview. So in this way, you can use this option that is a two tangent surface for creating the sweep. So again, I will just control save it in the same folder with the two tangency surface, and just I will close it. So let's move on to the third type. So we'll see here. So here this is the third type is circle. We have completed this explicit, we have completed this line type, and now we'll move to this circle type. So there is one mistake here, that is the two guides. So it should be the three guides. We'll see that three guide option in this with the example. So let's go to the start shape and the generative shape design. So here I will add the three guides. Sorry. Three guides. And then click OK. So now again, we'll see the options and we'll see the inputs required for this. So now just change this profile type to circle, and here there are again multiple options available for creating the sweeps. So the first option, that is the three guides, and you can see here the requirement is the guide curve 1, guide curve 2 and the guide curve 3. So total three guides are required for the creation of the sweep. So again, you can see in this picture, that is a G1, it's a guide 1, G2 is a guide 2 and G3 is a guide 3. So we'll see how to create this with the example. So we'll create the guide 1, guide 2 and guide 3 first, and then we'll use the sweep option. So let us create this guides here on the top plane. So I will use this line option, line command, and just create the guide 1. So now my guide 1 is created. Similarly, create the guide 2 on the same plane. But make sure that each of the guides must be in the different sketches, not in the same sketches. So again, use this line option and then exit here. So now my two guides are created, and we will create the third guide on this z-axis. So just make offset, or you can directly use and you can draw in the side plane. So just reverse it and swap this. Just click OK. So create the third line, that is the third guide. So now you can see this is the first guide, this is the second guide, and this is the third guide. So we have these three guides with us. Now we can use this option. So just go to the sweep command, and then you have to select the guide curve one by one. So just select the guide curve one, then the middle one in the same manner, and then the guide three. So if you preview it, you can see here the circular profile is created. That is the sweep command. So similarly, here you can find multiple options available, relimeter 1, relimeter 2. Again, you can add the plane in between and you can restrict the surface. So just try adding the plane once again here, and just offset from this plane in the reverse direction. Just click OK. Again, if you preview it, it will be restricted at that plane. Again, if you add the relimeter 2 here, just select this plane here, select in the reverse direction, and if you select the second plane here, so you can see here the profile is created within these two planes only. So in this way, you can use this command with the three guides to create the sweep. So again, I will control save this one with the three guides in the same folder we have created. So just save it, and now I will just close this. So we'll see the next command, that is the two guides and the radius. So again, we'll see with the help of example. Go to the start shape and the generative shape design. So here add the name, that is two guide and radius. Just click OK. So again, go to the sweep option and just select here the two guides and radius. Now you can find here the inputs are the guide curve 1, guide curve 2, and here we will require the radius. So two guide curves and the radius. So again, go to the top plane and create the guide curve here. So this is my guide curve 1. Similarly, I will create the guide curve 2. Just exit the workbench. So I have these two guide curves and I have to create a sweep surface. So I need to provide the radius. So go to the sweep command and select the guide curve 1, select the guide curve 2. So now here I have selected guide curve 1 and guide curve 2. So now you can see here, if you click preview, there may be an error. So you can find here there is no solution for this operation. This is because this line and the center, or this line, this guide curve 1 and the guide curve 2, this distance is not fitting within this 20 mm radius. So if you see, if I double click this one, so we'll just clear, use this. So you can see here the radius, the distance between these two lines we are getting, it is 81.519. So and if you provide the radius as 20, so the diameter is getting only 40 mm, so it is not fitting. So we have to provide the radius, at least its double must be 81.519. So again, I will exit this one, and again I will go to the sweep option, select the guide curve 1 and the guide curve 2. So now if we will see, if you add 81.519 divided by 2, So if we add this value here, and if we preview it, you can see here you will find the complete circle you are getting here. And if you add more than that, you will find the multiple options available with this. So again, if you try adding 40, it is going to be shown error. So because it is not fitting inside, so that's why it is showing the error. So it must be, let's say 50. And now you can see here the solutions, and you have around 1 to 6 solutions. So you can use the solution as per your requirement. You can find the sweep here. Again, if I go to this side, so you can see the sweep is getting changes. So now again it is getting changes. So in this way, there are 6 possibilities over here for this kind of sweep. So I will keep this first one as it is. And now again, you can add the relimiters here, relimiter 1 and relimiter 2, to restrict the surface within that 2 planes or surfaces. So in this way, you can use these 2 guides and radius curve. So make sure that the radius must be equal to the distance between the 2 lines, that is the 2 guide curves, half of it. So half of the distance between the 2 guide curves must be there for the radius, otherwise there will be an error with a no solution. So just click OK. So in this way you can use this sweep. So I will again control as this to save, and I will just close this option. So now we will see the other option, that is the center and 2 angles. So with the help of center and 2 angles, we will see how to create the sweep. So again, start with the generative shape design here. So add the center and 2 angle, and just click OK. So again, just click on the sweep option to see what are the inputs required. So now you can see the center and the 2 angles, and the inputs are the first is the central curve. So we have to provide a central curve, and then there is a reference curve. So 2 inputs we have to provide. So just create one by one. So just select the sketcher option and just create this center curve here. Just use the line again, and we'll create a simple center curve. Then just exit it. And now again, I will use this first the plane definition for creating the offset. Just create the on the offset, that is 60 mm, and now just sketch on this plane here. So just click on the normal view, and now I'll just select this line again, and we'll create one more curve here, that is a reference curve. So now we have this curve, center curve here, and we have this reference curve here. So now we'll create this sweep. So go to the sweep option and just select the center curve here, and then select the reference curve, and just try previewing it. So now you can see here the angle to mention here, that is 45 degree. So within this 45 degree this sweep is created. So again, if you just try increasing this one, or you can add this in the minus direction. So just preview it. So you can see here, with reference to the reference curve, the center curve is getting swept here. So you can add complete value over here for creating the sweep with the center and the 2 angle. Again, you will have the relimiter option here to restrict the surfaces. So in this way, you can use this option, center and 2 angle. So again, I will just control S this one, and just save in the same folder. Just close this window. And now the next option, that is the center and radius. So now with the center and radius, we'll see how to create the sweep. Again, start with the shape, go to the generative shape design, and now here just write the name of this one, that is center and radius. Just click OK. So now again we will go to the sweep option here, and we'll understand what are the inputs required. So now you can see here the central curve required, and then you have to provide the radius. So you can see here the GC, that is the central curve. You can see here the white line, and this yellow is the radius we are getting, that we need to provide this radius, that is R, that is in the green section. So just create the center curve here. We'll select, create this center curve. Sorry, just create the central curve in the top plane. Just create a vertical line here and then exit this workbench. So now we have the central curve and we can provide the radius. So just go to the sweep, select this central curve option, and then keep this radius as it is. So, and just preview it. So we'll find the sweep is created with the help of central curve and the radius. So you can try changing this radius as per your requirement. Again, you can add the relimiter option. Just try adding those again here. Again, create the point and make a offset. Just create this one and just click OK. Sorry, it's not intersecting this profile here. So again, go to the sweep and just select the center curve here. So just try once again. Just add the relimiter here. Again, add the plane. Just create a plane over here and make it offset. Let's take as it is, that is minus 35, and then preview it. And then you will find here, if you preview it, you can find the relimiter is added here. So similarly, you can add the relimiter too, and then just click OK. So in this way, you can create the sweep with the help of curve and the radius. So again, I will just save this and then just close this one. And now move on to the next option. That is the two guides and the tangency surface. So we'll understand with the example how to create the sweep with this. Again, go to the start shape design, generative shape design, and add the name of the file, two guides and tangency surface. And then click OK. So again, we will go to the sweep option and we'll just select here the two guides and the tangent surface. So for the understanding of the inputs. So now you can see here we need the limit curve with the tangency. So first input, that is a limit curve, and that should be with tangency. And then there is a tangent surface and the limit curve. So we have to provide these three options for the completion of this sweep. So we'll see how with the example how to execute this one. So again, if you see here in this picture over here, so a limit curve with tangency, so that is this surface over here. So we are getting this surface, and this G1 is the limit curve with tangency, and this G2 is the limit curve. So we have to provide these options here, and this is the tangency surface, that S defines the tangency surface. So let us create this profiles here. So I will draw on the front plane and just create this simple profile for the semicircle. Just exit this workbench and then extrude this one. Again, I will randomly extrude this. So now this is my tangency surface, and now this is my limit curve with tangency, and now I have to create the limit curve. So again, I will sketch on the top plane here. Just make this swap so that it will be properly oriented, and then select create the limit curve here, and then just exit this. So now I have this tangency surface, I have this limit curve with tangency, and this is the limit curve. So now go to the sweep command, and here select this limit curve with tangency, select this edge here, and then select the tangency surface. This is my tangency surface and this is the limit curve. So you can see here, this is the tangency surface, this is the limit curve with tangency, and this is the limit curve. Don't confuse with these options here, and just preview it. So now you can see here, there are again two solutions available. This is one solution. If you preview it, you can see here, if you click on OK, you can see here on this side, and there is other side as well. So if you see this second option, so you can see this is in the second direction. So these are the two solutions available at this point of time. So again, I will use this first option. So this option I will prefer here, and again you can add relimiter options here. So in this way you can use this limit curve with tangency surface and limit curve to create this sweep. So again, I will just controlize this one. I have to save this file here and just close this one. So again, move on to the next, that is the one guide and the tangency surface. So we'll see again with the help of example. So go to the start shape and the generative shape design. So let us add the name, that is one guide curve and tangency surface, and just click OK to open the new file. So again, we will go to the option here. Let us try selecting this one guide and tangency surface, and now you can see what are the inputs required. So first is the guide curve one, and second is the tangency surface, and here you have to provide the radius for that. So these are the three inputs required for this sweep command. So again, if you see in this picture over here, you can see the guide curve one. So this is G is the guide curve one here, and the tangent surface is, this is the surface you can find here. So let us try with this example. So let us create the profile here. Simply will create a profile. And then just extrude this one. So this extrude it randomly here. So this is my tangent surface, and now I will create the guide curve here. So let us create the guide curve again on the top plane. So this is my, sorry, I'll just delete this and draw it once again and just extrude this. So now I have this guide curve and the tangency surface available. So now go to the sweep command, and now select this guide curve one and select the tangency surface, and if you click preview, so now you are finding the solution error again, that is there is no solution. So now again the same error is because of this radius is 20 mm. Again, if you see, if you check the distance between these two lines, it must be greater than 20. So again, try changing this radius here. Let us try 60. Again, it is going outside. So now you will see here. Let us try checking this. How much is this? just select this measure, select the line and select this edge. You will find here it is 141.837. So you can directly copy or you can use the other options available here. So now again I will extrude this one, exit this one, and then just select the guide curve here and select the tangency. So now I will just paste that value here. That is the distance between this line and this edge. So now if you preview it, you will find here the solution. And again here there are two solutions available, that is one and the second one, that is this upper side and the lower side. So these are the two solutions available. Now you can see here, this is the upper side, and if you just select this first one, this is the lower side. So again, if you just try changing this one, so you can change this at any point of time here. So now you can see it is completely matching with this length. So in this way, you have to make sure that radius issue, so there should not be an error with no solution. So again, you can add the relimiter 1 and relimiter 2 options. So you can try this. So again, if you add this radius below this value, it is showing the error. So let us try 140. So it is again, it is happening it. Sorry, we are providing the radius. So that's why it must be equal to 70 here. So if it is below 70, or you can see here, if it is 69, now it is showing error here. And again, if you provide the 71, so it is showing the solution here. You can see here now it is having only one solution here. So if you try changing this value here, let us try 89. So now again, there is only one solution here. But if you go beyond, let's say 140, so now you have here two solutions. So depending upon this radius. So in this way, you can use this option for creating the sweep, that is one guide curve and the tangent surface. So I will just save this example here and just close this one. So move on to the next one, and that is the last one, that is a limit curve and the tangency surface. So we'll see this last option for this circle profile type. Again, let us start with the shape and the generative shape design and add here the name, that is the limit curve and the tangency surface. So just click OK. So now again we will go to the sweep option here, and we will understand what are the input requirements for this command, that is the limit curve and the tangent surface. So here you will have to find the limit curve, and then there is a tangent surface. So two inputs and with a radius, so we have to provide the radius as well. So now if you see here the limit curve here, that is L, this is a limit curve provided here, and there is a tangent surface. This surface, that is S, it is a surface which is tangency, and the radius we need to provide. So see one by one here. So now again I will draw a profile in the front plane. Just select these options and then exit this one. So extrude this to get our tangent surface. So now go to the swept option. So now see here the limit curve, this is a L here. So if you select this edge here as a limit curve and if you provide the tangent surface, and just let us try in preview. So you can see here the sweep is added here. So if you just add this angle, if you increase this angle here, so let us try, and the next option, that is, there are two possibilities once again here. So in this way you can see here the surface is added here. So let's make this one zero. So now I will preview it. So now it is in the continuous form. So you can try changing this radius as well. I will again increase this angle somewhat, and then you can see here the surface is getting added here. Again, try changing this one, and you can see here the sweep is created. So now I am using this solution here. If you want the other solution on the other side, so just select this first one and then you will find the other solution here. So this is the one type, and again we will see the next type here. So I will just save this as a one, and I will just copy this, just save this option, and so just close this. Again, we will create one more document here. One more example we will see, and I will just copy paste this one, and I will add this second, that is, for the second option we will see. So again, immediately I will create this profile here. Similar profile I have to create. Just extrude this. Again, I will just add the random extrusion. So now I will just create one offset plane here. Again, that will be with a random length here. And now I will draw on this plane. So what we will do, we will create one profile here, and that will project on the surface. And with the surface, we can use as a limit curve. So just create a line here, just simple line that we will project on this curve here. So just go to the project option, that is a projection, and keep this as selected, that is a projector sketch, and just select this support on which you want to project it, and just click OK. So again, I will modify this one and keep some bigger length here. And now exit this workbench. So now you can see here, this is my limit curve available here. So now I have this limit curve and I have this tangent surface. So now again, go to the sweep and then select this limit curve and tangency. Just select this as a limit curve and this as a tangency, and then try previewing it. So now if you preview it, we'll find here the two options. So again, I will click OK. So if you see down, you can see here the surface is added. So again, try making some changes here. So in try increasing this radius also, make a preview, and just I will add here, or you will use this other options. So now you can see here this sweep is created. Again, if I want to try this one only also, I will keep this as along the direction, and just select this direction as this z-axis. So it will be completely covered this circular face. So you can watch my earlier tutorials regarding the projections. So again, I will go to the not in the project. Again, I will modify this sweep command here. So now I have these two options available. So you can see this is from the inside, and this is from the first which we have seen is from the outside. So again, I will make this one active. And now here, just try adding minus 45. So now you can see it is taking the orientation on the other side, and just click OK. So again, here you can add the relimiters options. You can use these relimiters for the restricting the surfaces once again. So you just try it. If you have any queries, you can add it in the comment box. Just try increasing this radius and just make a preview of it. So to make it bigger one. So in this way, you can use these options for creating the sweep. So just we'll try hiding it. And in this way, you can create a sweep. So again, I will control S this for to save and just close this document. So now, till now we have seen explicit type, line type and the circle type. So now the last type, that is the conic one. So in conic, again, we'll see the first option, that is the two guide curves. So let us see with the example. So start with the shape and the generative shape design and add a name, that is a two guide curves. Two guide curves, and again here I will add the conic type and just click OK. So now again we will see the sweep command. I will understand what are the input requirements. So now we have seen this first one, that is explicit. We have seen this line type, we have seen this circle, and now we will see this last topic, that one is conic. So now here the first option, that is the two guide curves. So here we have to select the guide curve 1, then the tangency for the guide curve 1, then we have to provide the last guide curve, and that is the second guide curve, and with the tangency. So here if you find in this picture here, that is a G1 is the guide curve 1, and this is a T1, that is a surface, that is a tangency surface or the tangency plane we can provide here. Similarly, in here second, that is a G2 is the second guide curve, and this is a T2, that is the second surface, that is a tangency surface. So let us create these curves and the tangency surfaces one by one. So I'll just cancel this one, and now let us create first the two planes. Select this plane here in the reverse direction. Let us add 50. This is a plane 1, and similarly create a plane 2 on this side, that is with 50 once again. And now I will just draw on this first plane. So I will create this guide curve 1. So just simply create this line, and then similarly I will draw on this line here. So again randomly just create this line here and then exit this. So now I have this guide curve 1 here, I have the second guide curve over here. So now go to this swept surface function, and now select the guide curve 1. Just select this guide curve 1, select the tangency, this plane. You can select the plane as well as the surface. You can see here the surface is available, and as well as you can provide the plane. Similarly, select the last guide curve, that is the second guide curve, and the tangency surface, and then you can just preview this one. So now again here you will find the error, that is the geometric sweep with a conic section, two tangents are collinear. So now here just try changing these angles here. So let us try changing this angle here and just make it preview. So now you can see here the parabolic or the hyperbolic features are created with this help of sweep command. So now again if you try to change these angles over here, the different profiles similar to parabolic and hyperbolic shapes you will get. So in this way you can try these options here. Let us try adding the minus sign so that I will get it on the other side. So in this way you can create these sweep surfaces. Again, similarly you will have the option that is relimiter 1, relimiter 2 here. So you can try changing this one, and now here you will find the parameter available. So this parameter can be set as a for the parabola, for the hyperbola you can set these parameters as well. So I'll just click OK as of now, just to understand this function here, the command here, and I will save this in the same folder. So now we'll move on to the next command here, that is the three guide curves. So let us try creating the three guide curves and the sweep according to that. So let us close this one, and now I will just start with the new shape design, and here just add three guide curves and just click on OK to create this file. So now similarly I will create here the first two planes here. Just try creating, let us create with a 50 and 50 on the other side and just click OK. So these are my first two options. So similarly I will go to this option once again, and we'll just understand here from here what are the inputs required. So now you can see the first option is, that is the guide curve 1. So you can see here the guide curve 1, and this is the tangency surface. For this one it is required the tangency surface. So this T1 you will find here, it is a tangency surface, and the guide curve 2, and then there is a last guide curve and with a tangency. So now you can see here this is a T1, there's a tangency surface 1, and this is a guide curve 1, then there is a guide curve 2. So it is not required for this guide curve 2, that is a tangency surface, and this is the guide curve 3, that is the last curve, and for this the tangency surface is required. So now we have these two tangency surfaces here. Now we will create the guide curve 2 here. So let us create the guide curve here and just click OK, and now I will create this guide curves here for these tangent surfaces. Just create this first one, I will just create from this origin itself, just exit this workbench. Similarly on this plane here, in the similar fashion I will create the straight line here for the guide curve, and now create for the third, that guide curve that is on this plane here. Just swap it and just make this one, sorry, this is reverse, and then I have to keep this unchecked, and here I will again create this guide curve here. This is my middle curve. So I have this first curve, second curve, and this is the third curve, that is the last curve. So now go to the sweep command and keep this option selected, that is the three guide curves, and select the guide curve 1. Let's select this one and select the tangency for this one. So this is the first guide curve with a tangency. Select the second. So for this one, there is no tangency required. And the last guide curve, that is this one, and you have to provide this as a tangency. So now try changing with the preview. So again, there is an error. Again, try changing this angles here. So let us increase this angle here and just try. So you can see here with a 1 degree angle, it is going to create the sweep surface, because with a 0 degree angle, it cannot be. You can see here, this is a 1 degree here, so it cannot start the curve from the 0 degree. So again, you can see here, if I try changing this on the in the same direction, it is going to show the error. But whereas if I try changing this in the other direction, it is going to be fine. So in this way, you can use this option, that is the 3 guide curves, for creating the sweep. So again, I will save this one, and now I will again close this option. So now let us try for the third option, that is the 4 guide curve. So again, we will try for the 4 guide curves here. So again, just create this generative shape design and 4 guide curves. Just click OK. So now we'll go to the sweep option. Again, we will first understand what are the inputs required for these 4 guide curves. So now you can see here the guide curve 1, for which the tangency surface is required. Surface or plane you can mention here. Then there is a guide curve 2, guide curve 3, and last guide curve, that is the 4th guide curve. So for 2, 3 and last one, the tangency surface is not required. Tangency surface is required only for the first guide curve. So if you see in this picture over here, you can see this T is representing the surface, tangent surface. G1, that is the yellow line, this is for the guide curve 1. This is G2 is for the guide curve 2, G3 for the guide curve 3, and G4 is nothing but the last guide curve. So let us create the one by one. So let us first create the surface here. So let us select this sketch positioning and just draw on this front plane here. I will create a simple profile here and just escape this one. Just modify this little bit and exit this workbench and just make extrude for this one. Just make a random extrude here. So this is my tangency surface, and you can see this first is my first guide curve. So now we'll use this offset plane here and make it in the reverse direction. And let us create at a 20. Similarly, select the second plane here, and again on the second direction. And let us try, let us add it in the 40. So now sketch on the second plane. Again, make this in the proper alignment. And just create here a line for a guide. Similarly, sketch on the second plane here. Make it in the reverse and then click OK. So now I have this 3 guide curves. So this one is first, this one is second, and this one is my third guide curve. So we have these 3 guide curves here available here. So now again I will create one more this plane here. Just select this plane. And add to offset to plane. So again in the reverse direction, you add. And here I will add, let's say 30. And click OK. So just select this plane here. Again, I will click on the sketch and just reverse it in the direction and swap it for the alignment purpose. So now I will create this third guide over here. So you can just try with the trial and error. So I have created this three guides and this one, that is a limit curve we can use here, and this is the tangent surface. So now we will try this option. So just select the guide curve one, just select this guide curve as a one and select the tangency for this one. Similarly, select the guide curve two. So this is my guide curve two here. This is my guide curve three here. And this is my last guide curve, and just try previewing it. So similarly, we'll have these errors here. So again, here, just try changing these angles here. So this is the way of using these commands here. You can try more and you can graph these commands so that you can use it as per your requirement. So you know, you can see here the guide curves are used and the swift is created. So again, we can try changing this guide curves here. We can modify it. Then try modifying. So we'll just exit this workbench. Similarly, I will modify this one as well. And just exit this one. So in this way, you can use these options for the four guide curves and create the swift. Now the last command we will see that is with the five guide curves, this one from the conic type. So let us save this here and just go to the last option, that is the generative shape design here, and with a five guide curves. Mistaken the spelling here. So yeah, so now again we will go to the swift command and select the five guide curves. Now you will have to provide the guide curve 1, 2, 3, 4 and the last guide curve. So now you can see here, this is a curvature type area and the guide 1, guide 2, guide 3, guide 4 and guide 5 you have to provide. So now let us try creating this guides here. So I will offset this one. Let us add first 250. Then we have to add, let's say 25. And then we will use this middle one. So now go to this first here. And just try creating again. We'll create the straight line only. Then exit this one. So now just go to the second plane. Sorry, exit this one. Go to this plane here again. Make your orientation proper. And here I will just create one more. So exit this one. So now this is the first guide curve, this is the second one. Now we will create the third one on this plane. Just create this third one and then exit this. So now this is the first, this is the second and this is the third. So now again we can use these planes here for making the fourth one. So just create one by one. Just exit this one, and then create the last one that is on the again on the top plane. This is the plane. So similarly, I will create one more guide curve here. So we have this total 5 guide curves available now, and now we can use this one. So just hide these planes. So it is creating the mesh here. Just hide this one. So now again go to the sweep command. Just select this guide curve 1, guide curve 2, guide curve 3, 4, and then the fifth one. So again just try previewing it. You can see here the proper sweep is created, and then just click OK. So similarly, you can again add here the relimiter 1, relimiter 2. You can add here as per your requirement to restrict the surface within the two planes or the surfaces. So now we have used this last option. So now we have understood the four types of sweeps, main four types, that is explicit, line type, circle, conic. So again, I will save this one. I will just close this here. So thank you for watching this tutorial. I hope you have understood it very well. If you like this video and if it is really found helpful for you, please do like and share it. And if you have any queries, then you can add it in the comment box below. And don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get notified for the upcoming videos. So thank you very much.